I'm Emma Brunel, I'm 48 years old. I've been transitioning for 4 years now and my operation is due in 2 weeks' time. Earliest memory of not feeling like I conformed to gender norms was at age 5, when I remember going to school one day and seeing some of my friends dressed in dresses. It was on a non-uniform day. And I asked my mum why I couldn't wear a skirt to school, and she just said because boys don't do that kind of thing. I also remember dressing up in my mum's clothes and shoes when I was small, which when my mum found out that I was doing that, she went absolutely ballistic at me and told me that I shouldn't be doing anything like that because it's wrong. But I never cross-dressed all the rest of my life because I associated it as being dirty and wrong and something I shouldn't do. All the rest of my life going through school, I never felt like I really fitted into anything. I considered myself to be very chameleon-like. I would adopt things I was supposed to do. My mother found it difficult. She still uses my dad's name occasionally, though she is trying. But my dad was an absolute sweetheart. And all he said to me was, don't wear bright red lipstick, it'll make you look like a tart. I have 2 children, always been more maternal towards my children. It's not to do with the transition that upsets me most about the fact I had to leave my children. My ex-wife wouldn't, she, despite the fact that she making it perfectly clear, she didn't particularly like the children or dealing with them, so I lived with her after we decided to split up for, it must have been about a good 8 months, because I didn't want to lose my children. And then she did something that made it the situation untenable and I had to leave, and that absolutely tore the soul out of me. And I don't really think I've particularly still got over it. That's one thing that I do struggle with, but thankfully my children are fine with me. They both fully accept me. My son especially is really, really supportive. I have been manhandled in a pub in a personal way. That was quite shocking. You get stared at sometimes, certainly when you're starting to transition and you look more masculine. That's quite disturbing when people are staring at you. I've even gone over to someone in a pub that was staring at me and asked them to stop. And when they said why, I said, well, in my situation, if people are staring at you, it can sometimes end horribly. And if there's no malicious intent in what you're doing, then I'd rather you didn't, because I'm uncomfortable. Occasionally you get comments in the street, but I tend to wear headphones on permanently so that I don't ever hear what anyone's saying, and so I just ignore it anyway. It can be quite nerve-wracking because I travel by train on days when there's football matches and there's groups of lads that you're aware of could be talking about you. Quite often they're not, but it doesn't stop you from thinking the worst. But I always tend to, if I use public transport, I always weigh up where I'm best off sitting to avoid anything which is on permanently. But usually things are okay, but you never know, you don't want to take that chance when it isn't.
And it sounds like you can be quite vulnerable, Emma.
Yeah.
Decided to change your name to Emma?
Yeah, that was 4 years ago. I decided on January the 1st in 2013. And the night before, we had arranged a party with friends and we'd decided on a theme of Stars of the Silver Screen so that I could dress up, because me and my now wife were due to get married on May the 4th of that year, and I was acutely aware that the feelings that I was experiencing were getting more and more intense, and I didn't want to get married and then have to tell Heather that I wanted to become a woman. So we arranged this party, and then it snowballed from there. I dressed in a dress that day, and Heather said it was fine. And then I started asking questions, that whether she'd mind if I started doing it at home, and she said that was fine. So I thought, I'll see whether I can push this as far as I really want to go. So one day, I'd been doing that for a couple of weeks, and then one day I'd had a week off work, so I'd just lived as a woman all week, and I couldn't go back to being old me. So I then said, is it okay if I live as a woman all the time? And she said yes. So, because the main thing was, I didn't want to get married, and then it come out, and then I decided to change my name. That would have been on the January the 24th, something like that. For changing my name straight away. So
that must have felt very liberating for you.
Yeah, the strange thing is, I only just consider myself to have a personality for 4 years, because all the years prior to that I've been trying to fit in with how I'm perceived to exist, and I've never actually been a real person, whereas now I have my own interests, my own hobbies, and they're actually mine. I am Emma, I'm a person, and prior to that I didn't particularly exist. My operation's due in just over a week.
Wow.
With gender dysphoria, the bottom line is, you don't perceive yourself, the body doesn't fit in to how you see yourself. And I find myself, when I'm showering or things, it's my genitalia, the most distressing thing, and they always seem to grab me back to a past life. So obviously surgery was for me. It's not for every trans woman, because that's not what defines us, but for me it was a necessary step to go. And when I was given the go ahead that they'd agreed that I'd had the two referrals, it was just absolutely, I was ecstatic. It was just fantastic news. Yeah, so I feel absolutely delighted about that.
And I can tell, I'm full of emotion for you. It's brilliant. Did you have counselling before your pre-ops?
Yeah, I've had a lot of counselling, because people obviously need to be sure about what you're doing, because once the operation's over, it's non-reversible. So it's a long process. I've been on this journey for 4 years now. Okay, I would have liked it to have been quicker. Some of it's been delayed by professionals being sick, but I fully understand why it takes so long. And yeah, there's a lot of counselling, which is probably the worst part of it, because there's a lot of your past that you just bury and you don't want to bring up, and obviously people want to talk about it, so when you're then talking about it, it's, as you can tell, it can get quite emotional.
Thank you, Emma.
Is
there anything else that you would like to add before we finish?
No.
When I live my dream, I'll take you with me, riding on a golden horse. We'll live within my castle, with people there to serve you, happy at the sound of your voice.